I earlier announced that the Media Development Authority, or MDA, would be introducing co-regulation for the arts through a term licensing scheme, or TLS. This two-tiered scheme will allow arts group to self-classify performances that fall within the general rating under Tier 1, while Tier 2 licensees will be able to self-classify performances up to the restricted 18 rating. It aims to empower arts group with the responsibility of self-classifying their own performances while being mindful of community standards and expectations. To provide for the TLS, the Public Entertainment and Meetings Act, or PEMA, will need to be amended. MCI is currently finalising the amendments to the Act. We aim to conduct public consultation on the amendment bill in the second quarter of 2014. Madam, in preparation for the implementation of the TLS, MDA is reviewing the Arts Classification Framework, or the ACF, to ensure that the classification guidelines are sufficiently clear when used by arts group to self-classify their performances. Last year, MDA consulted with various stakeholders, including arts groups and the larger community, including MDA's advisory committees on both the TLS and the ACF. Let me share some of the feedback which was gathered. On the ACF, both arts group and community stakeholders asked if the review would result in a tightening or a loosening of the content standards. I would like to clarify that the MDA does not, at the onset of a review, unilaterally decide to loosen or tighten the standards. Rather, it aims to calibrate our content standards to reflect the majority view across society, taking into account views from both the arts industry and the public, including parents and consumers. The consultations on the TLS attracted diverse views. While some arts groups questioned if term licensing would result in self-censorship, other stakeholders, including parents, were concerned the MDA no longer classifying all arts performances might result in a relaxation of standards. It is important for us to remember that the TLS represents the first step towards MDA's co-regulation with the arts industry, taking into account societal norms. It provides an invaluable opportunity for arts group to partner with MDA to contribute towards an art scene that is both vibrant and socially responsible. MDA also received feedback on issues related to the implementation of the TLS raised by arts groups, and this included the responsibilities of the term licensees vis-à-vis the content assessors, the duration of the training hours required, and the consequence of misclassification. Ms. Koh also asked about the challenges to implementing the TLS and the revised ACF. We envisage that term licensees and their content assessors will need time to familiarize themselves to self-classifying their performance using the ACF. Therefore, Madam, in addition to the training which MDA will be providing to all content assessors, MDA will be conducting a pilot of the scheme in the second quarter of 2014 to test the processes and allow arts group to clarify issues before it is formally launched. So in conclusion, let me reiterate that the TLS is an important step towards a meaningful co-regulatory partnership between MDA and the arts sector, which takes into account our societal norms and values. The active participation of the arts group and feedback from stakeholders will be instrumental in ensuring the success of the scheme.